27 yards of offense in the third quarter for the Huskies. Brockington held to 2 yards rushing on 7 carries. Orlovsky the fake, throws it to the fullback Anderson, former New England high school wrestling champion, wrestled down at the 47. To look at some key plays, his team down 17-6. Jason Williams dropped one that would have been a big gainer that forced a punt. And right after the punt, a 49-yard touchdown pass to Henry.
And you know, this game's not over in terms of the chance.
14-33 left.
That would be a good point. But you know, you just feel like that Connecticut's just like not been here offensively.
Just a little bit off offensively all night long. Only 2 field goals tonight for the Huskies, who came in averaging 30 points per game. Third down, they're setting up a screen to Brockington. He waits nicely for some blocks. And one of the few big gains of the night for UConn. Cornell Brockington, 17-yard to the 35-yard line of West Virginia. And I would agree with you. You know, you're down by 3 scores here. You need to be a little more
in and out. Get in the huddle and move. Yeah, exactly. I mean, this is a nice call underneath. And what's going on now is West Virginia is going to bend and not break. Let the clock chew up. But go ahead and take it, Connecticut. Don't try to push things down the field. And see if you can't get Brockington to break a big one.
4 receivers spread the formation. And a deep handoff. That hasn't worked all night. That is just way too slow to try to get outside against this speedy West Virginia defense. Mike Lorello, who scored on the interception return, up to drop that play for a 2-yard loss.
And West Virginia's defensive line is just a big, strong, burly group that's controlled, most of the time, controlled Connecticut's offensive linemen.
Ben Lynch in particular, he's been injured this year, and that has held him below the form he demonstrated last year. But he's been excellent tonight. Play clock running down to 6:05. You wouldn't know they were down by 18 points at the pace they're moving. Brockington tried to spin free and could not. Jay Henry, the sophomore from Tulsa, Oklahoma, played on a state championship team at Jenks High School, a great high school program in Oklahoma, made the tackle. He's on just about every special team, in addition to being a backup linebacker for the Mountaineers.
West Virginia's defense, the longer they've been out here tonight, you know, they've had a lot of injuries, have been kind of banged up, nicked up. It just seems like they've started coming together and feeling it and playing better as a unit.
Chris Bellamy, the running back now, with 3 wide receivers and WVU showing blitz. Well, they rush only 3. Orlovsky zips one. Nice catch by Karan Henry. At the 24-yard line, a ball thrown behind him with some heat. He still managed to catch it in his hands for a first down.
And you know, again, the tempo, clocks are moving right now. You got to get in the huddle. You can make a call and get to the line of scrimmage. But the hands on Karan Henry, the way he goes inside, drives, sets up.
Very nice.
And he was being held, too.
That one catch just about makes him the receiver of the night on both sides. With the drop balls we've seen here this evening. Orlovsky 5 for his last 5. That one was good for 9 yards and a first down. Again, the play clock all the way down to 4 before they snap it. And Chris Bellamy is ahead to the 21-yard line. The senior from New Britain, Connecticut. He's also played some wide receiver here at UConn. He's a fifth-year senior with good speed.
Connecticut's really, their personnel group changes. 2 tights, they run the football. And they come in now with 3. Karan Henry and his group comes back on the field and gives you a passing formation.
11th play of the drive. Bellamy stays in as the running back with 3 wide receivers. Again, the play clock down to 6. And the catch, is it a catch? Yes, it is. For Kataya, who gets out of bounds to stop the clock. At the 12-yard line, the 2 officials are conferring about the call, and now the call has changed. Originally ruled a catch, but the field judge, Keith Parham, stepped in and said, no, it was not a catch.
Well, what? I mean, how would Randy Edsel know if he was in or not from all the way across the field?
I just think he wants to know why the first guy called it a catch.
Well, we'll see here. He's got control and both feet in. Right foot's down. I don't think so. You know, not from up here.
You don't think it was a catch?
No.
I would agree with you. They got it right. In the end, that's the most important thing. Third down and seven. Orlovsky sidesteps the rush and then threw it to somebody in the first row. He just had that one slip out of his hand. Well, it's fourth down and seven. The field goal only
give you 15,
15 points.
Yeah, two more scores.
He gave one eight-pointer, one two-point conversion in there. So he's going to take his chances and go for it on fourth down and seven. Just about an absolutely must convert if they're going to have any chance of winning this football game tonight. All but one defender up on the line. Orlovsky had hit, batted down, incomplete, and West Virginia will take over and downs. Jeff Nochel, who's a backup but has played a lot tonight, and he's been excellent.
And you know what, Nochel, you've said his name several times in this game, and what you've got to notice is that when they're coming in, they've got two blockers for the one guy, Nochel, up top on the right side. You got a tackler was trying to come out on him. You got a ball carrier trying to block him. They got confused at the line of scrimmage because they were showing blitz. They pulled out of that, and they messed up the tackle coming out to help the back.
We talked about the difficulty on first down in the first half of the Mountaineers, but they've corrected that and then some here in the second half. And here's another quality gain for Pernell Williams. And a late flag thrown in the secondary after the ball carrier Williams had been tackled by John Fletcher.
Sean, do you detect that he's not happy there?
I don't think he's been happy at all tonight. Can't blame him.
He's going to have one of them Old Testament meetings.
You know, they're going to win tonight just because they're the more talented team. But if you play like this against a good team, and they have a pretty good Syracuse team coming up next, you're not going to win.
No. You think they're a top 25 team?
They haven't played like it tonight. I think from a talent standpoint, they are. But, you know, they were the co-champs of the league last year and picked to win it largely because, you know, Miami left, Virginia Tech left. But these guys lost some good players last year. They lost Grant Wiley, they lost Quincy Wilson, they lost Brian King, they lost Lance Frazier, all of whom were in camps or still on practice squads of NFL teams.
And then got nicked up.
Yeah, K.J. Harris is injured. I don't think they're as talented as they were last year. But I think people looked at their schedule. So really the only two major games you look at as problem spots are Maryland and Virginia Tech. Then it's the rest of the Big East and a week rest of the non-conference schedule. I think that's why their ranking was so high. People were projecting them to have a great record, not necessarily evaluating it strictly on the talent. Again, I don't want to diminish their talent, because I do think they have borderline top 25 talent.
And I fell in the category. I had them high. You know, it was and I think you're right. We did, as analysts, we all looked at it in college football fans expecting them to be undefeated. I think Rasheed Marshall's better than I thought he'd be.
Chris Rodriguez needs a hug. I don't blame him, though. You know, they get a quality gain on first down, a stupid penalty away from the play. Cost them the gainer, sends them back, and now they have to punt and give it back. Oh, my gosh.
Well, if he didn't like that, he really won't like this punt.
They open with two tight ends. Rocking in the lone back. Orlovsky looking down the middle as a tight end wide open. Dropped again. Dan Murray had a touchdown, and he dropped it. Great call. Nice throw by Orlovsky. And Murray, usually sure-handed, he had a 61-yard touchdown catch against Murray State. Dropped it.
Yeah, that would fall under the old, boy, I cannot believe it. He's coming right down the middle of the field. Murray is there. Linebackers didn't drop into it. Oh. Very well thrown. Right in the bread basket. If Rich Rodriguez and Randy Etzel could have a pity party together after this one.
Rockington, nothing doing. I don't know about that call either. Remember the drop long pass that would have had them in business last time at the end of the third quarter by Williams. That throws too far ahead of the 29-yard line.
Yeah, so you know what? Not only do they blow a timeout on a fourth and a bus ride, but they turn the ball over, and it's returned almost to where the line of scrimmage was.
He was looking for Kataya. Looked like he might have gotten his hands on it, but couldn't hang on. Pernell Williams, the freshman. Tough run. They took the red shirt off him tonight, Craig, and it looks like he's a guy who could definitely help. He said, they've been telling me all year I might play. But this time, this week, it sounded a little more serious. He had a pretty good idea he would get in there tonight, and he has.
Look at West Virginia. At the line of scrimmage, put the pressure on, tempo's up. Rich Rodriguez is trying to get his team to that A-game level.
Well, I would think ahead by this score, you wouldn't snap the ball with 10 seconds on the play clock, and they won't. Marshall snapped it with six. And Williams has the first down. John Fletcher made the tackle at the 41-yard line.
Yeah, you're right, though. This kid is not just a freshman in body. I mean, he's out there running hard. Williams is... Did you just drop your whole pile of paperwork there?
Yeah, it did.
But Williams, you can see, again, West Virginia always recruits and has good running backs. They always sure have, always will. It's just who's the next guy?
8 carries, 41 yards rushing for the true freshman. And he's ahead for 4 more to the 45. Here's Holly Rowe.
Well, guys, as you said, Pernell Williams getting that red shirt taken off him tonight, but he has been so conscientious. After his first 2 carries in the first half, he would go over to the sideline and talk to the running backs coach, make sure he was doing the right thing. He's trying to get his assignments right and make sure that he's on the same page with the rest of his offense in his first big action this year in game 6.
The only thing he needs to make sure of is whenever it's a passing play that he knows who he's going to block, but running the football, just run with your eyes, your feet are going to follow you.
And they rush for 200 plus. They win under Rich Rodriguez. They're going to be 22-3 with that number when this one is over. There's another first down. Alfred Fincher and John Fletcher made the tackle. That's a 7-yard gain for Williams.
Here's those eyes that I'm talking about, Sean. Watch once it gets to everybody. The defense is stretched out. Everybody up front. There it is. Bus goes back to the backside, and his eyes find the hole. And once you get behind that last blocker, get north.
Rich Rodriguez gave him a well-deserved pat on the shoulder there. The loss at Virginia Tech snapped an 11-game regular season winning streak for West Virginia. Dating back to last year, they're going to be back in the win column tonight. Jason Colson, the ball looked like it came out after he hit the ground, but no whistles. And it's run back by Justin Perkins. West Virginia sideline indicating they thought Colson was down. Rich Rodriguez hollering at the officials, but he's not going to get the call. And Connecticut takes over near midfield with 7:08 remaining.
And you know what? Great effort by the defense down the field to trying to strip the football. And
that is a fumble.
That it came out, didn't it?
It did.
Well, obviously it came out. Did it come out before he was down? Yep, ball's coming out. Two hands on the ball. Second, third effort's great, but you got to cover it up and know the game.
From their own 49. Orlovsky chased out of the pocket and runs out of bounds for a loss on the play. Credit them with a sack. Ben Lynch and Keelan Dykes chased him out. Sports Center coming up next. I know we will be tuned in, both big baseball fans. Last I heard, the Red Sox were trailing the Yankees 3-0.
Yeah, and the Astros tied up.
No chance for your Astros against the Cardinals in this series.
Yeah, your Red Sox got a big chance.
Second down and 13, exactly 7 minutes to go. Orlovsky hit as he throws, and he's fortunate that fell incomplete. Jason Hardy put the hit on Orlovsky, the converted offensive lineman.
He's also lucky that he was able to get up on this. When his arm goes back, it hits his tackle. And then it's a club sandwich.
Well, Rentschler Field rapidly emptying. It was sold out with 40,000 fans to watch West Virginia and Connecticut play football against each other for the first time ever. Big East opener for the preseason conference favorite West Virginia. It was a tight game at the half, but the only scoring in the second half has been two touchdowns by the Mountaineers. On third and long, a catch for a first down. Kataya showing that excellent speed we spoke of earlier. He's finally pulled down by Anthony Mims inside the 20. All the way down to the 17 goes the 37-yard gain.
Nice job of throwing the football. Last time we watched Orlovsky throw the football, he didn't make these throws across the middle of the field. Of course, now he's showing you that he can. He make all the throws, but top guy up here. Kataya's going to come across. He's got plenty of time to throw the ball this time. Orlovsky steps up, shot across the middle.
We're thinking about how this might be different if Murray had held on to that certain touchdown pass earlier in this quarter. Came away empty on that drive. Orlovsky zips one toward the end zone. There's a good catch and a over the ball. Check that. Tony Cherubino, the backup kicker, is on the field. He must be their onside kick specialist.
We'll see how special he is.
They were offside. They recovered, but they were offside. Taking off from the 30, they stayed onside, but that time the kickoff went right in.
Could have hit the road. Lots of red taillights out there. And this is only an 11-point game.
Pernell Williams, the ball carrier for a gain of two.
See how easy the kick was with his leg. The second bounce goes high. Now here's, watch how hard he swings it. See how he changed it, the delivery of his leg. You're looking at me shaking your head.
Oh,
like,
was that, sure. That was good. I had not noticed that until you pointed out, and clearly it was true.
Okay. I was a kicker. Not a soccer style, but I was a straight arm kicker. You didn't know that either, did you?
Mr. Square toe?
Square toe.
They missed the handoff, so Marshall keeps it. And it's a great game down to the 20-yard line. James Hargrave made the tackle. 18 yards on the run for Marshall.
Creeping up on that all-time Big East rushing leader for quarterbacks.
Yeah, he is. He has 110 yards on 18 carries tonight, so he needs 44 more to catch Donovan McNabb as the Big East all-time leading rushing quarterback. .537 to go. Speaking of Donovan McNabb, Syracuse, the next opponent for West Virginia in 8 days. That'll be next Thursday night. Mike Tirico, Kirk Herbstreit, Lee Corso will be in.
Yep.
Up the middle, Williams. There's the first touchdown of his collegiate career. Pernell Williams, the freshman, in from 13 yards out.
Can you keep the ball in college?
No.
I don't think so.
Don't believe so. Well, the only folks still here are those hardy souls who have made the trip from West Virginia. 75 yards rushing now and 13 carries and a TD for Pernell Williams. And plenty of backs to choose from now for Coach Rodriguez. We'll get K.J. Harris back eventually. Jason Colson, certainly a solid back. He's had a career high in rushing tonight with 111. And now Williams has joined the stable. The extra point good for Cooper.
That's what he's talking about. Coach Rod wants to see him finish strong, and this is what you do when you're a freshman and you're wanting to run hard and poor tackling defense. You just don't have quite, you know, we don't see number 9 Fincher ever miss like that. You know, your dauber's in the dirt.
Larry Taylor and Matt Lawrence back deep. High and short kickoff. Down to Lawrence at the 18-yard line. And he brings it back to the 27, a 9-yard.
Themselves, it would be Sean.
Sean is often wrong, but never in doubt.
He could build a case for both sides with his own mind.
Swing past Chris Bellamy. And he's out of bounds at the 30. A 3-yard gain. Pac-Man Jones made the tackle. I don't think I would have Pac-Man in the game were I the West Virginia coaching staff, one of their most valuable players, maybe the most. Well, he wasn't that happy for long, was he? Rich Rodriguez, by the way, just got a very nice award, prestigious award from the FBI for his involvement with the FBI. He's been involved in, among other things, a program designed to get fingerprints of young children when they come to football games. They get copies of their fingerprints, which are stored in the FBI's fingerprint holding area, which is very near Morgantown. And that way, God forbid something should happen, a youngster gets lost or abducted, it could help them find that youngster because they have the fingerprints on file.
It is a great thing, and it's a nice award for Coach Rod. And the thing that struck me when you talk about the holding tank area is it's a place where you and I need to stay away from. We don't need our fingerprints anymore.
Dan Murray made the last catch. Second and short, Orlovsky throws to Williams for a first down. Many faces of Coach Rodriguez tonight. And that pass behind Henry. And incomplete. With Jamal Adai in coverage. Well, the bottom line is, it is going to be a win. It hasn't been an artistic thing of beauty, but it will be a victory.
And at the end of the day, it's a big win. On the road, you knew you were playing against an opponent that you hadn't really worked and seen before in Rensselaer Field, and it's a sold-out environment. It was hostile and national TV.
He started out as a head coach at Salem College, small school, and after 1 year as the head coach, the program was taken over. The school was taken over by a university from Tokyo, from Japan, and they dropped football.
He's one of 17 Division I-A coaches who are coaching at their alma mater. Did you know that? How about that little nugget?
It's a fun fact that you just pulled seemingly out of midair.
It's a touchdown. When I can get something beyond you, it's a score.
I knew that, though.
No.
But he was one of, I said earlier, oh, you knew, he played defensive back.
But did you know there were 17?
Yes, I did, because I read the same exact notes that you read that the fine Shelley Poe, Sports Information Director at West Virginia, puts out.
I thought Shelley
like
sent
name
me that.
Some of the others without looking at my notes?
Well, I could do that too.
Go ahead, name one. For everyone you name, I'll try to name
Art Browse, Houston.
Orlovsky throws one to Chris Bellamy. He's inside the 15. Al Groh.
Mike Shula, Alabama. I'll go ahead and give you another one. Jeff Bauer, Southern Miss.
Frank Beamer. John Bunting.
Houston Nutt, Arkansas.
You're running out of 17. First and 10.
I got the truck
notes
in my ear helping me.
The truck is helping you in your ear.
I don't need
it. This was way
no,
too
I
fast.
Not. No, I don't need a run. I've already said Jeff Bauer.
Said our number one goal really is the Big East Championship. And that is still obviously very much in front of them. 3 minutes to go. Connecticut. First and 10 at the 13-yard line. And a catch made by Henry. Out of bounds at the 4-yard line. Pushed out by Lawrence Adina. This is just about the entire first string defense in there for West Virginia, and Connecticut is moving briskly. Yes, this is why you keep your first string defense in too, because another score could make it just that much more anxious for Rich, who has already been a little anxious tonight. Second and one at the 4. Jason Williams, the motion man. Low snap handled well by Orlovsky. He zips one through the hands of Jason Williams. Boy, he throws some pretty hard passes, doesn't he?
He has
some
to, because they're covered
up. Actually caught tonight.
Yeah, and you know, playing against good teams like this, you want to have the ball in your hands, but you got to have strong hands, Sean. Watch here again. I mean, this is a look at that right there. That's a bowling alley.
Yeah.
You know, there's another drop touchdown.
Third down and one. 2:51 to go. Oh, Orlovsky wrapped up, and hopefully they'll be able to hear the signals over the crowd noise. Orlovsky keeps four wide receivers. Orlovsky down passes for Connecticut, so it's a three-way tie, the all-time lead, and that ball is a little too far for Henry. He caught it, but he was well out of bounds. So the try for two needs to go 10 yards. It did, and it looks like the Huskies have it. Bounced off a couple of players on each side. Balls, particularly early in the game. Orlovsky still in there. Intent to dump it off, and Bellamy runs out of bounds at the 50, a gain of two. There's Rashid. He's had a very nice career at West Virginia and still plenty to play for, including, they hope, another Big East championship.
I'd have to say the co-player of the game would be Coach Rod with his facials. He's had some emotionals.
I think he worked harder than anybody tonight.
He did. He's got to be tired.
Well, certainly Mike Lorello was a candidate with two interceptions, including one run back for a touchdown. Orlovsky throws short again. Orlovsky and these Huskies battling to the end. And it's intercepted. And run back by Jeff Nogel. Marshall still at quarterback. And it's Pernell Williams. That wasn't as difficult as I made it, that's for sure.
Hi, guys.
Puppy's a bulldog.
There's Pernell again. You get the sense, didn't you, that the coaching staff is a little irritated with K.J. Harris? Not they said so in as many words, but you get the feeling they wish he would play with some of these little nagging injuries.
And if, yes, and the fact that Jason Colson, that fumble that he had going down the field that turned around, led to a touchdown, all those things keep you on the sidelines. I always taught that if you fumble, you might as well take 50 yards off whatever you've done for that night.
K.J. Harris not involved in the action tonight. West Virginia goes to 5-1, 1-0 in the Big East. Connecticut 4-2 now. 1-2 in the Big East. Final score, West Virginia 31, Connecticut 19.